long time no see. I have been doing a lot of different stuff. Reagan and I just bought another property that I think I told you about in the last video. That was an Indiana property. The other one was in Ohio. We've been spending time with family. I've been spending time with my boy, hanging out with Reagan, and I took her shopping yesterday, and just trying to enjoy, you know, some family time. I don't know, just more like unscheduled life. A few days of life is just something that I don't think a lot of people truly sit back and let themselves do. And what I mean by that is not having a set plan or schedule for your day to day for a handful of days and just like let life happen and enjoy little moments. You know what I mean? I've been trying to do that for a little bit here because we're taking a break, I said, between this giveaway and the next one, like we usually do them back to back. But with that Whistling Diesel First and giveaway, it had gotten us all backed up, which got us backed up on the Dually giveaway a little bit. So we're thinking within the next, I think in the next week and a half now, maybe 10 days at the most, we should have all of the orders that were placed on our website shipped out, which means that we can start our next giveaway. But we want to get that done first. That way we can get back on the agenda, which is quick, fast, super quick shipping, which is what we wanted to do when we first started it. But then we got the first gen from Whistling Diesel, and then sales exploded beyond what our normal was, and we just were not prepared for that. So even though we were hiring employees and stuff, we couldn't hire them and train them on how to do it fast enough with orders still coming in to just like get all caught up overnight. You know, just it doesn't work like that. And we should be all caught up here within the next week to 10 days, and then we're gonna start our next giveaway.
Okay, we're gonna try to do a start, and I'm terrified. I'm gonna need the keys to start it, so I'm gonna have to go get the keys.
You don't have the keys?
No. So this is how you properly skin a coyote. You just take this, my brother, like this, and you walk. Hopefully the twine will come undone. Yanking his mother, brother.
Cut.
Let's give him some more air, bro.
Guys, make sure you've got it held in the position that it's gonna completely block it off. 100%.
Got it.
Is it held in
the
hand ready? Okay.
Yep. Wait. Is the battery supposed to be smoking? I feel like I'm dead serious. You saw that? Goodness, something good old electrical fire up in here.
Oh boy, the nerves are high. So yesterday we were gonna start this, and I had two other guys out here that were going to assist with this recording and engine possible having to stop and stuff like that. But today I'm solo again. It's off days for everybody else, and I still gotta try to figure this thing out. So I'm gonna set my camera up like I did the first time, and I'm not so sure that the last time was actually runaway. I think it was, some guys pointed this out in the comments. He's like, that's scary. But that's not as scary as a runaway. Runaway is much worse. Apparently they said that it sounded like it was more just like topping out in terms of like revving at like, you know, 3,500, 4,000 RPM, but it didn't sound like it was like, you know, a freaking runaway. You know what I'm saying? But I'm not saying it wasn't completely, because I really haven't truly experienced it if that's not what it was. So I can't say that it was or wasn't, but hopefully that is all that it was. I disassembled the pump, put everything back together. It appears to be correct. But again, I said the same thing last time, which is about a week ago. So hopefully this time it's actually back together properly again, but this time legitimately properly, and we don't have an issue. But what I'm gonna do is start the truck and instantly get out and grab the board versus like start the truck and let it warm up and then come out here. If stuff starts to go bad, I'm just gonna start it. And while it's starting to, you know, warm up a little bit, unlike last time where I let it kind of go and then start build up, I'm just gonna start it and then immediately get out here with the board and then just kind of listen to it and wait, you know, if I have that kind of time, I don't know, but hopefully I do. And then that way I can just kind of listen to it and see if it actually needs to be stopped or not, but hopefully not. Fingers crossed, let's try this. So the truck started, but I didn't have to kill it with the turbo. I just instantly, after it started, and it went from like just hardly starting to just full blown, like high idle, high throttle, whatever, full throttle, I mean. And so what I did was just turn the key off, and it just killed the truck. Now that was kind of a risky thing to just kind of turn the key off and just kind of, you know, see if it would turn it off, but I wanted to see. I was ready to jump out of the truck, but I just turned the key off real quick before I did, just to see if it's not actually like quote unquote running away, and it might actually just be way too high of an idle type of deal, and maybe that's just what's causing it to seem like it's running away, but it's really just like 4,000 RPM, which still isn't like great or close to that, I mean. But at least that would mean it's not running away, it's just getting way too much fuel somehow at quote unquote idle, and that's what's making it seem like that. But so now we gotta figure out what that is. So the first thing we're gonna test is taking this idle screw here, see that there, and backing it down some more and getting it closer to the pump by about, I'd say half of that gap, and see if that at least fixes it first before tearing into the pump again. We did bump the idle screw back by about 50% of what it was set at right now, because there's a very good chance that I just put it in and completely forgot about needing it to be in a certain position, otherwise it would high idle like that. So at least we know it's a high idle now, so if it screams, I can just kick the key off, but still got the board ready. We're gonna go and see if it'll start up here. Might need to prime for a sec, but not too much, because all we did was pop out the two banjo bolts and put them back in. So hopefully the idle's back down, so we at least know what the issue was. The idle did start out a lot lower, than it was, but it did start to pick up pretty quick. I mean, it went from like idling kind of low to starting to rev, you know what I mean? So still had me a little bit nervous, but I could still just hit the key off and it turned off, which is good. There might be a little bit more to it than just that screw. We'll have to dig around a little bit more. On our way to go pick up Rosine. This thing needs washed again, but we're all hooked up and ready to go. Well, we got Rosine picked up.
He's actually selling it if somebody wants to buy it, otherwise it's not technically listed for sale.
I'd sell it. I mean, it's an awesome truck.
Yeah, it's for sale.
Yeah. I mean, I think it's got 250 on it. Yeah, it was a 2500 converted to a 3500 with a crazy stance. And people, there is no spacers on the front of this. There's nothing. Like, all the only thing that is on here is an 8 to 10 lug adapter. No spacers.
That's crazy.
And it's dance for days. People are like, oh, take your dually adapters off. I don't have any.
That's crazy, because the hub is all the way on the outside of the wheel. That's nuts. That's crazy. So, you had a lot of fun with this truck a little while.
Yeah, the red one?
Yeah.
Oh, it was a peach. Swapping axle, welding in new trays.
Custom brake lines.
Yeah, to get custom brake lines. So, it was awesome.
He said he wants to do it again, so.
Yeah, I know.
That's it for here. Check him out on Instagram.
Till next time.
Yeah. Next day. This video is going on like 5 days of pieces, so I'm just going to end it today. And then pick up and get little bits and pieces for the next couple days and get you another video. So we did hook up the car hauler to the Whistlin' Diesel third gen, which, by the way, a winner should have been called today. Can't guarantee you that, but a winner should have been called today. The entries are with the administration that does the drawing, so they should be able to get that done. Rosine is on the trailer. She's all lifted, but not done. Rosine needs a few components. Apparently, Rosie needs a different front track bar for the steering. The axle's off like a 96 or a 97. The truck is obviously like an 01. So the steering stuff just kind of doesn't like line up perfectly. So this wheel is like nice and flush, and then that far one's like towed out. Not quite the right front track bar. So it's enough to get it like on the trailer, but the new one's got to be put on there before we can, of course, drive the truck. You're gonna have some major issues, but you can see parts of the lift here. It's a Rough Country 5-inch lift, and we went with a Rough Country 5-inch lift with a 2.5-inch spacer on it. So the truck's got a total of 7.5 inches of increased front clearance, which is just massive. The thing is huge. It's not done yet, but it's getting there. This has been a project for sure.
He said it was probably one of the least fun ones he's done in a long time, probably since the blue Chevy budget build that we did way back. And due to having to convert that axle to this truck and suspension and modify and weld and just a lot of different things, everything lined up good, like everything seems fine, but it's just, you know, one of those fun projects that had to do a lot of modifying to make it work. It wasn't just a cookie cutter lift kit install, you know, because of the axle swap and all the other stuff. But four-wheel drive works and everything. We locked it up and we pulled it onto the trailer and it just engaged and all up she went. I mean, just rolled right on too. So we're gonna take this to get the air bled out of the brakes. We tried to do it at Devin's shop, but he said that there's just too much and he can't do it with just, like, you know, cracking the line with a wrench and then doing it that way. He said he's gonna need actual air bleeders and he doesn't have any. So we're gonna have to take this to the shop locally to have them bleed all the air and make sure the fluids are good. And then we're gonna get the truck back. Then we're gonna have to swap out this track bar with the correct one, but that's not gonna be too terribly hard to do, so I'm just gonna do that myself. And I think that's pretty much all it needs to be then ready to put the wheels and tires on to be able to drive the truck. I mean, I think that's it. I know that he said that he would recommend dual steering stabilizers as well, just because that'll definitely help with the steering with this thing being so big. But I mean, the main things are bleeding the air, topping off the brake fluids, and then swapping out the front track bar. That way we can drive this thing straight on down the road. I was gonna tell you guys give you guys some news before I was interrupted by the sighting of a really nice buck making a scree back behind my pasture here. So I had to drop my camera, go grab my gun, come back, grab a grunt call, and try to see if I could get him to come over here. But that wasn't gonna happen because he was already gone by the time I got back about 5 minutes later. A little bit of news for the first gen. So you guys know we've been tinkering around on the first gen here, trying to get this thing to have the fuel pump properly function, which we're getting closer, starting to figure out the things, what it is and isn't, little by little. I did back the throttle screw way down so that the throttle would, you know, be cut way back. And believe it or not, it does help some, because the throttle went from, like, being, the truck sounded like it was at like 4,000 RPM almost, to then like maybe 2,500 RPM once I backed the screw way down and then started it back up, which is still way too high, obviously, for idle. But the point is, it went down when we moved the screw out more. So we're gonna tinker around with this a little bit more, little by little, just to get everything fine-tuned. Nothing's wrong with the truck, it's not broken. It's just, you know, the VE pumps are kind of sensitive to stuff. The P pumps are not as sensitive. You can rip the entire fuel plate out and other dumb stuff, and the truck will still idle seemingly fine. It might be a lot smokier or not be getting as much fuel, but it seems like the truck seems to just handle movements with the pump so much easier than, like, these are very, very sensitive to small turns of screws and springs, and everything is super sensitive, it seems like, on these pumps, and something could go wrong pretty quick if you're not careful. But we'll get it figured out. Nothing's broken on it, nothing's wrong. We're just trying to fine tune it and get it sorted out. We're almost caught up on orders, and now I say we're almost caught up, I mean, there's still some orders to ship, so I don't wanna see the comments, "Oh, mine's still not shipped yet." I said we're almost caught up. We're almost all caught up from getting backed up on orders from the two Whistling Diesel truck giveaways. So we're almost all caught up and we're almost ready to start our next giveaway. Might be another week or so still, but it should be happening very, very soon. And I'm actually debating this truck. Now, before everybody freaks out, and I know what the comments are gonna say, "I thought you were gonna keep that one for yourself. I thought you said you were gonna keep that one. You said you would keep that one." I get it, I see the comments, because that's what I said. I said, this is what I'm planning on building for my daily driver, for my truck, you know, whatever. Here's the issue, guys. I always think I'm gonna keep a truck, and I genuinely did think I'm going to keep this truck. But here's the problem. We have the Cadillac, we have whatever giveaway truck we have at the time here to drive and use and stuff like that while we have it. We have Rosine now, that's basically done. All we gotta do is that couple things that I told you about. I mean, even just between Rosine and the Cadillac, where let's say we trade in the Cadillac and get a newer pickup truck instead of the Cadillac, either way, it's like, there's two vehicles right there. And we've got a newer one for long trips and stuff like that. And we actually got a deer rack on it for hauling deer for long hunting trips and stuff like that. Looks a little hillbilly, I'm not gonna lie, but I'm totally down to do that. Then we've got Rosine for smaller trips and stuff like that on days the weather's not that bad. And then whatever giveaway truck we have at the time, there's a third vehicle that we're always gonna have. We're always gonna have another giveaway truck in our possession that we can use in the meantime for little things here and there, whether it's just driving over to go hunting, running into town and back, stuff like that. All that being said, we're always gonna have three vehicles on hand. Whatever giveaway truck we have at the time, the Cadillac,
in Rosine, or if we're not having the Cadillac very long and we get a newer pickup truck. The point is, we'll always have three vehicles at a time. The point is, this truck most of the time is going to sit. Like if I have to go on a 2 or 3 hour trip, you know, haul a big load and haul a giveaway truck back, chances are I'm not gonna take this truck. If I have the option to drive a newer vehicle, like the Cadillac, and hook up a trailer if I have to go longer distance, or a newer pickup truck if we get rid of that, I'm just not gonna take this long distance and stuff. Like, this is a super cool pickup truck, like it's super stellar, but it's just not gonna get used enough to me justify sitting it out here behind the barn in the weather. And that's why it's so hard for me to keep a truck for myself, because I'm always like, man, like, it's cool, don't get me wrong, it's cool. Between keeping a truck for myself, let's say, and then we've got Rosine, then we've got the Cadillac. Rosine is that big red 24 valve on the trailer there. And then we have a giveaway truck. That's four vehicles at a time, and we can only drive one at a time, two if for some reason me and the wife have to go on separate trips or something, which rarely happens. I would just hate to see this truck get done here and then just sit. And that's honestly what'll probably end up happening, which is why I'm considering giving this truck away next and just sending it off to somebody that's actually gonna use it, because I just really do not need another truck for myself. It's been a long project, but we're almost done. The only things we really gotta do is the center console's gotta get upholstered. It's gotta get tinted. Gotta have the, something in the drive line. I think it's the carrier bearing or something, needs to get replaced. That way there's no vibration when you're going like over 50 miles an hour. And then we're gonna do an upgraded clutch in the truck, because the clutch is pretty wore out. I think that's pretty much it, other than some small things under the hood like injectors and stuff like that. If I do this as a giveaway truck, I'll just have that stuff done quick, take it to the shop, get a bunch of stuff done, get the upholstery done, and then basically the truck's good to go. I mean, it'll be done. I know we've had it a long time. We've done so much to it that people would love to see me just keep it, but I just hate to keep a truck that's just gonna sit, and that's essentially what it'll do. So hopefully, guys, I'll understand. Hopefully it doesn't upset too many people. I would love to keep the truck. I just feel like I need an excuse to actually finish it. And I feel like if I tell myself I'm gonna make it the giveaway truck, I'll actually finish the truck like within the next 2 weeks and just get everything done that I want to get done. But I've been pushing it off for so long because I'm like, I just don't drive the truck. I don't need to drive the truck. I've got other vehicles to drive. Like, you know, like, I just don't have to finish it right now. You know what I mean? Like, but if I tell myself I'm giving it away, I will finish the thing quick. You know what I mean? So I don't know, guys. Hopefully you guys understand. If not, I don't know what to tell you. I try to do what's best for the business, best for my family, best for, you know, being realistic and practical at times. I'll catch you in the next video. Peace.